I don't know about you, but I love nice cars. I love the way they look. I love just getting in them, the feel when you get in that seat, or the way that they accelerate. I mean, if you could afford any car on this lot, which one would you choose? I'm gonna show you the one I chose. It's the 1996 Subaru. Now, some of my friends think I'm crazy because they think, man, you could afford any car on this lot and this is what you bought. To me, though, I go, this is the only thing that makes sense, because the $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 I would save, I think, man, I could build an orphanage in Africa. And to me, I go, okay, what's going to make me happier 5 or 10 years from now? Is it going to be looking back at all those great drives I took, or will it be looking at these orphans that have been fed, that are eating, are full of life? To me, it's like, man, that just makes me happier. It's not like this sacrificial, oh, look at how much I gave up type of thing. To me, it's just, I want to be happy. And not only that, but I think about heaven and I think, okay, whatever I sacrifice on this earth, God says He's going to give me 100 times as much, and that's going to last forever. And so while people say I'm crazy, I'm going, man, who's the crazy one? The one that's thinking and investing and obsessed with something that he can't lose in heaven, or the one who's going to spend everything and know that he could just have his life end at any second? As you read chapter 8, what this chapter is about, it's the profile of the obsessed. I mean, what does a life look like that is obsessed with heaven, that is obsessed with Jesus Christ? And hopefully as you read this chapter, you resonate with it and go, you know, that's totally me. That's totally who I want to be.